Ron! Ron, oh my God, it's so great to see you. How you doing?
The makeup is just for TV. Damn!
Oh man, I can't believe I am finally on the JBL show. JBL, it is a pleasure to meet a man of your stature. I can't believe it.
I am so excited that the legend himself has carved a bust of me. This is the greatest thing I've ever paid for. I'm so glad you came down. This is my Christmas gift to myself.
Well, you deserve it. Are you ready?
Yes. 3, 2, 1.
JBL.
Wow! It's me!
It's you?
I love me!
At least I think it's you.
I'm gonna sleep with it. I'm gonna take it with me everywhere. I'm gonna put a pair of headphones on it. I'm not gonna put anything on the hair. The hair's perfect.
No, the hair's perfect. The only problem is we got a call. Somebody paid me a little bit extra, double in fact, to make another one. It was Cole. He paid me double, man.
It looks just like it. I wanna throw up.
Okay, so where's mine? He obviously made one.
I sent mine out to be clean. Just touched up just a little bit, and then I sent yours out. Don't worry about it.
But where is it? When am I going to have an opportunity to see it?
I sent it out.
Nonetheless, welcome to the JBL and Cole show.
Mine will be here next week on the JBL show.
And we are in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Penn State University, to be exact, was the site a decade ago of perhaps the most famous race in WWE history.
The entire company let out to watch this race, this challenge that unfolded.
Well, it was ring announcer Tony Schimmel.
From the Stone Age.
Versus Jonathan the Coach Coachman. Now, as the myth and the legend goes, Tony Schimmel
turned the company upside down that day.
Believed that he could beat Coach. So he made the challenge.
A tremendous athlete who now is one of the premier stars for ESPN.
Oh, he's a true star.
I did see Coach on, I think it was ESPN.
Tony Schimmel, anyway, thought that.
At 3 a.m. in the morning.
Tony Schimmel thought that he could defeat Coach in this race. In fact,
this man.
Coach was so confident that he gave Schimmel a 1 minute start. Right now, we want to bring you to Bristol, Connecticut's ESPN headquarters.
Unbelievable.
And hear the coach's side of the story, followed by Mr. Schimmel's rebuttal.
What's up, JBL? Yes, it's me. Blast from the past, the coach. First of all, I want to say congratulations on your new show. It looks like you and I have continued to rise to the top. You know what I'm saying? I understand that there's a Fred Flintstone type looking guy that's probably rolling around there somewhere just off to the side of the camera. A guy that for 10 years when I was there couldn't stop running his mouth. Don't remember his name, though. But I understand that he's been talking about some race at Penn State, that he beat this, that he beat the coach, the very man who used to stomp on his head day after day. Sorry. I don't remember either one, the person, the place, or a race. That's all I got.
So there you have it, from Jonathan the Coach Coachman.
Apparently didn't have it. Apparently
setting the record straight on what happened at Penn State University a decade ago.
Well, it doesn't surprise
Security,
me.
Security, could you please remove Security this man guys, from please, our set, please?
Please.
Thank
Wait
you very much. Nice to
I
join
won
you.
That.
Thank you very much.
I beat him.
Coach, thank you. And you're right, he's my sidekick. I'm like Johnny Washburn, or he's like Cheetah.
Well, I'm like Stuart Scott.
You're like Stuart Scott. Unbelievable. This is what I work with, Coach. This is what I work with.
John, come back! It's a great show! Well, nonetheless, thank you for joining us on the first JBL and Cole show of 2013. Happy New Year, everybody. At least I'll be back next week.